फ्रेंड्स, आई एम निशा शर्मा, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज खेतरी. द टॉपिक अंडर डिस्कशन टुडे इज अ क्रिटिकल एनालिसिस ऑफ विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ्स पोएम द सॉलिटरी रिवर. द होल डिस्कशन शैल बी डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री पार्ट्स. द फर्स्ट पार्ट विल मेक यू फेमिलियर विद विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ एज अ पोएट. इन द सेकेंड स्टेंजा विल मेक a stanza wise analysis of the poem Solitary Reaper, and in the third part we'll make a critical analysis of the whole poem. So now let's start with an introduction to William Wordsworth. William Wordsworth was born on April 7, 1770 at Cockermouth, Cucumberland, England. And he died on April 23, 1850. William Wordsworth's main works include The Prelude, Tintern Abbey, Lyrical Ballads, and Lucy Poems. Wordsworth is also known as Lake Poet and Priest of Nature. He belongs to the Romantic era of poetry, and we have already discussed in our previous lecture the salient features of romantic era. In his poetry, nature finds a sublime expression in his work. Just as Alexander Pope is known as a poet of town, William Wordsworth is known as a poet of countryside. Many other poets exhibited external beauties of nature, but none of them had seen a soul in nature, nor were they prepared to take lessons of morality from nature. William Wordsworth's love of nature is normally divided into four sections, and there was a development in his love of nature with his age. His love from nature grew from physical to spiritual love. Now we come to the poem The Solitary Reaper. We can discuss in this manner. The Solitary Reaper is a lyric. Just lyric, as you know, is a short poem. It is a very formal type of poem which expresses personal emotions or feelings and is spoken in the first person. Lyric's first part introduces the subject the poet is talking about. In the second part, the poet depicts the emotions which are aroused by the image. And the third part is the concluding part. The Solitary Reaper was published in 1807, and it was an outcome of Wordsworth's tour in Scotland with his sister Dorothy in 1803. The poem was suggested to or inspired by the description of a solitary reaper given in Thomas Wilkinson's Tour in Scotland. Now we come to the critical analysis of the text. The title of the poem, The Solitary Reaper, indicates that the subject of the poem is a reaper. Reaper is the person who cuts the crop. The adjective that the poet uses before her is solitary. Solitary means lonely or all alone. In the first stanza of the poem, the poet emphasizes our attention towards her loneliness by using words like single, solitary, by herself, alone. Thus, the subject of this beautiful poem is a highland girl lonely reaping the harvest. Wordsworth asks the imaginary passerby to take a notice of the Highland girl working lonely in the field. The scene is quite common during harvest time. The girl is reaping the harvest and she is singing a song. Though the poet is not familiar with the language, but her manner indicates that it is a melancholy song. The whole valley is echoing with her song. She is singing so beautifully that the poet would not like her to be disturbed by any other sound. Therefore, ही आस्क द इमेजिनरी पासर बाय टू स्टॉप हियर और जेंटली पास. दस इन द फर्स्ट स्टैंजा द पॉइंट हैज इंट्रोड्यूस द सब्जेक्ट दैट अराउज्ड हिज इमेजिनेशन. इन द सेकेंड स्टैंजा द पॉइंट मेक्स अ कंपेरिजन बिटवीन द स्वीट सॉन्ग ऑफ द सॉलिटरी पर एंड दैट ऑफ द कुकू एंड नाइटिंगल बर्ड. कुकू एंड नाइटिंगल बिलोंग टू द एक्सट्रीम नॉर्थ एंड साउथ रीजन. द सॉन्ग ऑफ कुकू इज क्वाइट जॉयफुल टू द ट्रेवलर्स इन अ डेजर्ट हु आर रेस्टिंग इन एन ओएसिस. द सॉन्ग ऑफ नाइटिंगल हेराल्ड्स द कमिंग ऑफ द स्प्रिंग सीजन एंड दस ब्रेकिंग द साइलेंस ऑफ द सी. वर्ड्सवर्थ आइडियलाइजेज द मेडन एंड हर सॉन्ग. He feels so excited and thrilled by the song of the Highland girl that he thinks her song is more musical than that of a nightingale or a cuckoo. The song of the girl makes Wordsworth curious. He wants to know the theme of the song. He assumes that she is singing a sad song of some past, age-old historical event or some battle. Or her song may be about some common sorrows and sufferings of ordinary life which have fallen on humanity in the past and may fall once again. The concluding stanza describes the effect of the girl's song on Wordsworth. The poet is no longer bothered about the theme of the song. He is concerned with its melody. The poet is greatly impressed by the sadness and wistfulness of the song that he hears and feels that it has created an unforgettable impression upon his mind. Thus we can say that the poem illustrates Wordsworth's theory of poetry, that poetry is emotions recollected in tranquility. He and his sister Dorothy had actually come across several such reapers singing while at work in remote parts of the Highland of Scotland while touring there. The journal of a traveller and the diary of his sister remind the poet of these experiences and the joy they had brought him. So he was inspired to write the poem. The next head is simplicity of theme and language. The Solitary Reaper is a simple poem dealing with a village girl. The emotions felt by the poet have been described in a very simple language, but the simplicity of language does not rob the poem of its melodious quality. The poem is as melodious as the song of the solitary reaper. The words carry us to the solitary world of the reaper, and the expressions breaking the silence of the seas among the farthest Hebrides and for old, unhappy, far-off things carry our imagination back to the distant world of romanticism. Now, there is a dramatic, democratic note in the poem. It is to be noted that Wordsworth strikes a democratic note so far as the theme of the poem is concerned. He chooses a simple, familiar peasant girl as the subject of his poem. This is something new in English poetry, because in the 18th century, the poets were mainly concerned with town life and town people. Wordsworth, who is a democrat and who believes in the quality of men, makes a simple Scottish maiden the heroine of his poem. In the poem, we also find a note of melancholy. The poem is suffused with melancholy. The Highland girl singing a melancholy strain as she reaps alone in the field expresses for the poet not a personal feeling but a melancholy suffused over vast areas of space and time, a song of common fate of men not only in battle but also in the most ordinary affairs of daily life. The poem is full of romantic effects. Wordsworth's imagination travels in time and goes to the dim, far-off past. There is the very essence of romance in these highly suggestive lines. Perhaps the plaintive numbers flow for old unhappy far off things and battles long ago. The language or diction of the poem is quite simple and pure. There is no art in the poem, only there is a sense of ineffability about every word used, about every image drawn. The music has a magical, haunting quality. The poet makes us feel what he himself felt. The Solitary Reaper is one of the finest lyrics of Wordsworth. One of the chief traits of the lyric is that it is spontaneous. Its appeal is not to the intellect but to the heart. In the Solitary Reaper, we find that imagination dominates the reason and thought of the poet. Wordsworth is so lost in the song that he forgets the sense of time. He treasures in his heart the sweet melody of the song. We can compare the poem with Wordsworth's famous Daffodils poem. The joy that Wordsworth received from the song of the Highland girl lingers in his heart even after she has stopped singing. This reminds us of the beautiful lines of his poem Daffodils. The beautiful sight of golden yellow daffodils had a similar impact on the poet when he says, "When upon my couch I lie in vacant or in pensive mood, they flash upon that inward eye, which is the bliss of solitude." Thus, it was customary with him to treasure in his heart the moments of joy which he experienced in his communion with nature. These moments of joy ultimately become sources of poetic creation.